where have you been?
I mean, the chief is about to go nuts ranting and raving about having your badge.
Yeah, whatever. If he'd taken my badge the last time he went off on one of his tirades, he'd really be screwed now, wouldn't he? So who's the party today?
It's Rex Kipler, again. This trap is set just so he can get you.
Yeah, I figured as much.
Where are you going?
To crash the party.
Sting, are you crazy?
Yeah.
His cronies are all over the house! Stingray.
Hey, Rex. Hi.
Hello.
She's real pretty, isn't she, Stingray?
Yeah, but she's definitely not your type, Rex.
My thoughts exactly. That's why I won't mind killing her.
Yeah, whatever. Miss, you got anything to drink in this place?
Yeah, there's cola, milk, and grape juice in the fridge.
1% or 2%?
Huh?
Milk, lady.
Oh, 2?
What's he doing in there?
Negotiating.
So you kill her. What happens next?
Might as well kill you, too.
What if I get to you first?
Oh, you're dreaming, boy.
Am I?
Careful now, Stingray. I could kill you first.
I don't think so.
Go in there and check it out and see what he's doing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Stingray.
No problem, lady. I can't resist rescuing a damsel in distress.
Oh, Stingray, how do you manage to be so reckless and yet so sexy?
Well, baby, it's just something I was born with. Oh, hey, Carl. Rex is in the kitchen. I should take him to the station while I finish my business here.
You know my lawyer would get me out of this thing, Ray. You're nothing but garbage. Oh!
return after these messages.
Commitment and mine are obviously too different.
This is why you discuss it like a normal couple should. That way you don't have to shove it down your boyfriend's throat.
Hey, Bert and Lonnie, how's it going?
Hey, Mark.
Go to hell, Mark.
Great.
Walter, we have discussed and discussed and discussed, and we have made zero progress.
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? Walter, you tell me what progress we've made in this issue.
Well, we weren't getting pretty good about our conversations about it until you decided to lose it again.
Lose it? What the... I thought you were going to talk about progress.
I was actually going to speak of you impeding our progress.
No, Walter, you have just discussed the history and the demeanor of our debates. You have yet to talk about how much has changed in terms of where our relationship is going. Why? Because it's going nowhere and has been for the past 3 months.
Well, we spent our quality time together discussing stupid stuff. It seems like we're stalling.
Uh-huh. That is the problem right there.
Uh-huh.
Yes! You think this is stupid. You must think this whole relationship is stupid.
I do not. You're putting words in my mouth.
Oh, really? How's that?
You never said the relationship was stupid.
Yeah.
Shut up, Mark.
Hey, I gotta listen to this jabber. Besides, I mean, if you're accusing my friend of saying something that he never said, then it concerns me. It should concern you, too.
Walter, when was the last time you took me to a movie?
One of my favorite characters.
I don't remember.
That's not good, man. Chicks are good with dates.
August 24th, that's when?
See? Told you.
Shut up, Mark! 2.5 months ago!
But you
so what are you saying? You want to go to a movie?
No! That's not what I'm saying!
Well, what are you saying? I mean, I figured I'd take you and there's something showing more than a sequel.
Oh, what difference does it make? When was the last time a movie was something I actually wanted to see?
Oh, another date question.
Oh, Mark!
Emily, what really are you?
November 12th, our first date.
Really? Wait a minute, last weekend we rented a movie we both wanted to see. Does that not count?
No, it doesn't. First off, we rented it. Secondly, it had that stupid actor in it that you like that I cannot stand.
Ha-ha! What is wrong with Rick Stingray?
First of all, there's no way that's his name. His name is probably Daryl Dumbass, and he changed it for Hollywood. Come on.
So? People pay to see him wherever he goes.
Well, I'm putting no more time into him or this relationship.
Oh, please, Em, don't tell me you're going to break this off over Rick Stingray.
Walter? If you think this is about Rick Stingray, you are more hopeless than I thought. Ugh!
I don't believe her. I didn't do anything.
I don't believe Rick Stingray is not his real name.
Man, if you don't lighten up, we're not only going to lose our sales for the day, we're going to lose our jobs.
Well, it's hard to forget about her when our sales this month emphasize Valentine's Day.
Look, if a chick dumps you because a guy's name isn't really Rick Stingray, she's a flake to begin with.
Hey, don't call her a flake.
Okay, how about a Fruit Loop?
No!
Ditzy chick?
No.
Airhead?
No.
Well, how about something stronger, like Bimbo?
Hey, if you don't stop, I'm going to hit you so hard.
Well, see, man, that's what I'm talking about.
What?
If you had just shown a little bit of that, a little bit of guts, I mean, a little bit of getting into her face and saying, look, honey, if you're not happy with me, there's the door, all right? And before you go off packing your 3,000 pairs of shoes and your 3,000 hats, remember this. You will never find a better lover than me. Never. Not in this city, not in this state, and especially not in this bed. Now, if you go off and you go find somebody else, you will never find a better romancing, kissing, love-making machine than this.
Sir, is she okay?
You pervert! I should call the police!
Yeah, you go ahead, old man. By the time you got to the phone, I could beat every house in this neighborhood and still have time to get away.
We'll see about that!
Ow! Let's go to another area first.
Yeah, okay.
I'm sorry, man, but today you were a real jinx.
Oh, really? Hey, I'm not the one that's giving the elderly residents their death certificates.
Look, man, that old man was doing nothing but meddling in business that didn't concern him or his old broad. I mean, you should have seen yourself today, man. I mean, trying to sell her Valentine's Day products.
It's like, this necklace would be a good gift if you're lucky enough to have a girlfriend. You see, my girlfriend left me, and I'm stuck not being able to order anything from the catalog, so you should take advantage of this special, lucky, oh-so-blessed opportunity of having a girlfriend by buying something.
I think you're exaggerating. Oh, am I? Who is watching you today, you or me?
You.
Right. Not to mention all the people who had to sit there and watch you sulk through it all.
But, that is only if they were fortunate enough just to see you sulk. Oh, yeah. And then there were those that got your evil eye after one of them happened to say they had a significant other. After your sulky speech, if one of them happened to say, oh yeah, my boyfriend would really love this, you got this really vicious look in your eye, like at any minute you were going to say, oh really, lady? Oh yeah? Oh yeah? And what makes your freaking boyfriend so great, huh? What makes you think he deserves a woman more than me, huh? And if it were a man talking about his lady friend, you'd look like you wanted to say, why do you want a girlfriend? Why do you want an evil little creature that'll pull out your heart and spit on it and chop it up and eat it and choke on it and digest it and pass it and flush it and burn the leftovers and then rip every part of you inside and out up and complain then about how she broke a nail doing all this?
Well, it's obvious that you just don't understand. What's to understand? We had a non-eventful, non-successful day. And what would constitute a successful day? I don't know. A good $300 worth of sales? I meet a couple of chicks that want to come by? A day where I don't spend the whole time walking up and down the streets?
That's funny, because even on good sales day, it requires us walking up and down the streets.
You know what I mean.
Yeah. I mean, but you know what I mean. Look at us. We sell crap out of a catalog. Every day we get up, go to work, sit on our butts, come home, go to bed, do it all over again. We have no life. That is our life. All I have to look forward to is I come home, I watch Rick Stingray episodes.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing is wrong with Stingray, but everything else is uneventful. We have no action, no adventure in our life. It's sickening. We have loser lifestyles. I mean, I don't know about you, but I want more out of life.
Right, well, if you want a prostitute, just say so. You don't have to give me a speech.
No, I don't mean in my love life. I just mean in my life.
So what do you want to do? Quit?
Yeah, don't you?
Well, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't lose any sleep over not working for them anymore.
But, I mean,
then what? I mean, if we do, we're going to go work for who?
I don't know. I've been kicking myself too much to think of an alternative. I just know I need something different. I just need to sleep on it. I just need something different in my life, some excitement, you know? I'm just gonna sleep on it.
Oh, hey, wait a minute. Don't you want to see the last few minutes of Stingray?
Well, I do.
Easy, turning now, now begins me.
just call me a backseat driver.
What?
Where's your boss?
What?
Where's your boss? Next time, that's gonna be the sound you're making. Now, where's your boss?
I don't have a boss. I'm a self-employed businessman.
Oh, yeah? You're a drug dealer. Or do you call yourself street pharmacist now?
Man, I don't know what you're talking about.
Truck.
What are you, crazy?
Yeah. Now, the longer you answer questions correctly, the longer I keep the drive safe. Got it?
Well, what if I hit the brake?
Not likely.
Man! That was my soccer foot!
Oh, by the way, the slamming on the brakes comment was a wrong answer.
Okay, man, I'm sorry. I'll tell you anything you want, just don't jerk the wheel. Oh, man, you're gonna give me some major whiplash.
Where's Osborne? He's your boss, right?
Yeah, but I don't know where he is.
Well, let's just park this car right into those trees, then.
Ah! The old Piper warehouse! He's been there for 2 weeks! You'll find him there!
You're sure?
I'll bet my other foot on it!
Okay. See? That wasn't too hard, was it? Probably similar to a good drug high, huh?
Yeah. I guess it kind of is.
Well, don't let me ruin all your fun then.
Stingray will return after these messages.
That's right, Maria. The people of Purdy are becoming less and less secure about life here. There have been a number of crimes on the rise in the last month, including burglary, muggings, vandalisms, and many others. This is a very small town with a small police force, and there seems to be no help from surrounding cities. I have the sheriff here, Jeb Jones. Sheriff, could you tell us a little bit about how you plan to solve this problem?
Well, we've been trying to enlist bigger towns with bigger police departments to come in and help us, but they're too busy. And, well, I ain't complaining. I understand bigger towns have bigger problems, and, well, my guys are doing all that they can, and we're working on a strategy currently.
Could you tell me a little bit about that strategy, or what that strategy might be?
Well, ma'am, I could, but if I did, one of those there crooks might see this interview and know exactly what we have planned to do.
Okay, well, let me rephrase. What could you tell the people of Purdy that they might do to stay safe at this time?
Well, being before dark, lock their windows, lock their doors, call us if there's a problem. If they see something suspicious, give us a call, and we'll respond to it as quickly as we can. We're a small force. We're doing everything we can.
So you want to say that maybe probably in the next month we should start seeing things really wrap up around here?
I would hope before the month is out, yes.
Okay. Well, I appreciate it, Sheriff. Thanks for talking with me.
Yeah.
Thanks. That's it, Maria. We're signing off now. You heard it from the sheriff. Everything will be taken care of.
Deteriorated, so did my interest.
So you're saying you've been losing interest long before breaking up with me? Oh, how long have you been losing interest?
3 months.
3 months. Oh, no comment was way better.
Look, Walter, if you don't want to hear this, then just leave me alone and move on. You know, this is just as hard for me as it is for you.
Really? This whole thing seems natural to you. It's like you're getting rid of an outfit that doesn't fit anymore versus getting rid of someone who's dedicated a significant portion of their life to you.
Well, you know what? That's a good analogy, because you don't fit anymore.
Here's the analogy so you would understand the issues we're dealing with.
I understand the issues. You are the one that doesn't understand my issues.
Well, if you are truly interested in a stable relationship, you'll take time to work things out instead of going out looking for a blind date.
I have been trying to work things out for 3 months now. I have finally just decided that you just don't understand.
Well, it doesn't matter who you date. If it is your way or the highway, you're going to find yourself moving on a lot more than moving ahead in life.
Yeah.
And you will find yourself single for a long time until you start to understand women.
Oh, I understand women. They're the sinister creatures that rip your heart out, throw it on the ground, stomp on it, pick it up and eat it again, and then complain about breaking a nail.
Mark?
You!
Going somewhere?
Yep.
Where are you going?
I mean, where are we going?
Okay, where are we going?
A place with action. Adventure.
New York? England?
Purdy.
Purdy. Why would we go there? They only have 10 people in their town.
Exactly.
I'm confused. What about work?
Already taken care of it.
Well, that's good.
We no longer work there. Effective today.
What do you mean we got fired?
No, I quit. I quit you too.
You can't do that!
I just did.
What are you talking about? We got bills to pay. We got the phone bill, the water bill,
we got all these bills to pay. Hey! Now, if you let me get to the part about where we got the new jobs.
Oh, great. Doing what?
Sit down, Walter. Walter, my friend, you inspired me the other day.
I did.
You did. And you were right. I mean, our lives stink. I mean, we are total, complete, brutal, bottom of the totem pole losers.
I don't feel like I went that far.
Well, long story short, I got us a gig to help us reinvent ourselves. Okay? I mean, it's got the action, it's got the adventure, and it might help us to meet a few chicks in between. Oh, hey, how did your thing go with Emily today? Well, good. No conflict of interest there.
Mark, what are you talking about?
All right. We're going to Purdy to be the new big-time cops in town. No, wait. Look, this is what it is. They've been having a real problem with crime lately, you know, and the big towns won't come and help them. So I kind of went down there the other day and presented myself to them as the big-town, big-time cop. And I offered to help them, but the thing about it is... You and I, we're really undercover. Huh? So if they start talking about us a lot, we have to leave. And they're too stupid to find out who we really are. They're just happy to have the help. So, the operation begins. At 1800 hours. So let's get moving. Oh, by the way, your new name is Stingray. And you better start getting used to calling me Carl. I told them that's what our names were.
here we come.
Sign we entered into town.
No, what did it say?
It said, "Welcome to Purdy, the purtiest town in Texas."
I was wondering where they got the name for the town.
How are we gonna eat? And what about money and a place to live and work? I mean, we certainly can't afford to commute every day.
Who's taking care of them?
Okay, elaborate, please.
To them, we're royalty. I mean, we might as well be kings in this town. They think that since we're big cops from the big city, you know, they think that makes us modern-day superheroes coming to save them.
Well, that still doesn't answer my question.
They've arranged for a place for us to stay. I mean, a place for us to work. They said eating wouldn't be a problem either. I mean, they answered all our problems. We'll make some money, and we've got room and board. It's already taken care of everything. Plus, no, I didn't exactly quit. You know, I got us an extended paid vacation.
What?
Why? We can still make our usual payments. Until I think of something else. And I will think of something else, so don't worry.
And you don't think the fact that we're not really cops is a problem?
No.
We don't have guns.
Yes, we do.
How did we get guns?
Picked up from a friend of mine.
Oh, yeah. Well, what about handcuffs?
Pleasure Palace, my friend.
You bought our handcuffs at a sex toy store.
Yeah, they had them.
I hope that's all you bought.
Was.
Mark, that was all you bought, right?
Hey, look, let me put a deal like this, okay? You wanted handcuffs, we got them, that's all that matters.
What's this?
Well, this is where I was told to come when we arrived.
Stingray, this is your cue to get out of the car.
I can't do this. I can't live a lie.
You're not. I mean, we're actually becoming Purdy's finest here. Come on.
Yeah, well, with real crooks, real bullets, and real crime.
No, this is Purdy. This is not New York. I mean, how dangerous could the local crime ring be?
I'm just not sure I can look these people in the eye and lie to them like this.
Well, then don't. I mean, look, I just set this up today. There can't be a whole lot of people that know about this. Now, come on. Look, trust me, when this is all over, you're really gonna thank me, okay?
Sure I will.
Okay? Now, if you're a little dizzy, you just take it slow.
What happened?
You fainted. Mr. Stingray, you don't want to rush it any time you lose consciousness. I know this because I lose consciousness so easily. One time I was feeding the pigs, and the little fence we have them in, it gave me a splinter. It drew a little blood, and I hate the sound of blood, so I fainted right there in that pig pen. I mean, splat, right there in the mud. Well, I was probably there all day long, but when I woke up, one of those male pigs was taken to me, so I rushed up out of that pen, ran to the well to get some water to wash me off. Well, I should have taken it slower, because I passed out again and fell in the well.
Lady, I'm a cop. Don't worry, I'm not going to do anything to harm myself.
Well, did you know there's a TV cop with your name?
Yeah, I knew that.
I think this is so neat. Stingray fighting crime for Purdy. At least she ain't pretending to be him, though. I had a cousin who pretended he was a country version of Evel Knievel. He was going to make his horse jump off a ramp and over 8 horse trailers. Needless to say, he didn't even make it over the first one.
Yeah, well, thanks. I gotta go find Mark. I mean, Carl.
Stingray and Purdy. That would make a really good episode.
Yeah, I need to take a vacation and I need some rates on some places. Well, let's start with Hawaii and Cancun. I need to leave tomorrow. Yeah, I can hold. Can I help you, beautiful?
Oh, man! This is your vacation!
You're like Stingray, aren't you?
In the flesh.
Then I know you can help me.
Really?
I need your help right away. And I'll do anything.
Cancel that order.
Oh, yes. Being a hero is going to have a lot of benefits.
You really think there are women that look like that walking around this town?
Could happen.
No, it can't. That's TV. This is reality.
Not anymore. This is better than reality. I mean, I got us a dream. We're living the life of all lives.
Mark, wake up. We are not Stingray and his partner, Carl. We're not even close. I mean, we're not even living in that world. We're not even close to the region the story takes place in.
Fine. You're right.
What are you doing?
You're right. The whole thing's a mistake. Now let's go back and sell some catalog products. Now that's a man's life.
I didn't say I want to go back.
You didn't say you wanted to stay here.
I'm just confused, okay? I can't be Stingray. I can't be anything other than myself.
But you can. And when that walks in here for the first time and talks to you, you will be amazed at how much it'll change your life. Believe me.
I definitely can help you, Miss Lucas.
Angie.
We'll talk, compensation later.
I'm looking forward to that part, most of all.
My husband's a worthless slob.
I'm sorry?
I told him over and over again, there's more to this world than sitting on your butt watching sports. There's things to be did around the house. The fence needs fixing, the toilet needs unclogging, the porch needs sweeping.
Okay. What does he usually say when you ask him to do these things?
What does he tell me? Well, let's see. He tells me to go fall down where I can't get up. Thinks he's real funny. Tells me he hopes I'll just go off and die somewhere. Says he's retired from work. He's worked enough. But he may be retired from work, but he ain't retired to my husband, not yet.
All right. I understand, but, what can I do for you?
We'll just lock him up. Make him miss me in his home. You might have to get your gun, though, to get him off that recliner. Hell, you may have to call the fire department to pry him off it. You know, like they do for the kids that get their tongue stuck to the flagpole in the wintertime.
Ma'am, I can't do that.
What you mean you can't do it? You're a police officer, aren't you? Don't you handle domestic disputes?
Yes, but marital communication problems are for psychologists, not police officers. I mean, domestic disputes are normally handled by law enforcement, but he's not breaking a law by not getting out of the recliner.
Just as I thought.
What?
Typical male, just looking after your own. You know you ain't gonna last. Someday you men gonna be begging for your jobs back, just begging for them back. One of these days, a young woman's gonna come waltzing through that door, and she's gonna be taking your job right out from under you. She's gonna be mean, and she's gonna be strong, and she's gonna have PMS 365 days a year. And then you'll see, we'll have a stable town inside out. Have a good day, son.
You too.
You can't tell me the events so far are what you expected.
Hey, all I know is that it's really early in the game. I mean, just because it's 0-0 at the end of the first quarter doesn't mean it's going to be that way the whole game.
I just feel like we're living in Mayberry.
We're not. We're living in Purdy.
Well, you know, I wanted to give this a second chance, but I just need actions to speak louder than words. I need proof this is what we thought it would be.
You want your proof? It's right over there.
Oh my.
It's Angie.
What are you talking about?
You know, from the Stingray episode.
There's no way that's Angie from Stingray.
Great, man. Come on. I mean, you wanted proof and now you're gonna be unsatisfied?
Well, we'll probably never see her again.
Well, look, we're undercover cops and we're the best. I say,
we follow her.
She'll see us.
Well, not if we do it right.
Okay, we follow her and then what?
I don't know.
Great.
Well, look, you want her to get away or not?
Okay.
Well, come on, let's go.
Stingray?
What have we accomplished?
We have successfully pursued the subject without being noticed.
Yeah?
Now we must meet her.
How?
Follow me, Stingray.
Ah! Help, Stingray! He's got me! I can't get him off! I'm coming to use your intensive intuition to get him off of me. I don't want that scumbag to get that girl. I'm knocking flat, Sting.
We're in a charity mood, Rex. So just take us up on that offer by getting out of our sight.
Yeah, if you've ever want to walk again? Get out of here, you slime ball!
Yeah, so get out of here, Rex! You guys are crazy!
Yeah, we're crazy and we're dangerous, too!
Yeah, okay, Sting.
And I can't help a damsel in distress like that, just...
Yep. Okay, you got the point.
Good. You okay, ma'am?
Yes.
Good.
Who was that guy?
That was Rex. He's an evil person. He robs money from elderly people, uses women, and he steals farm animals. I suggest you stay away from him.
Huh. So, you guys are the two new heroes in town?
That's us. I'm Carl, and this is my partner, Stingray. Huh.
So, you're sure you're not just a couple of guys who watch too much TV?
They're good code names. You know, we're from out of town, and we're trying to keep low-key.
I can tell. Yeah, so, Are you as good as a cop as the one on TV, Stingray?
Huh? Yeah.
Better.
I guess the two of you guys have quite the reputation in the big city.
I've held my own.
Oh, well, I could tell you some stories. Like that time he knocked out the entire army during a hostage situation.
Right.
Yeah. And, you know, when you took care of that plane hijacking all by yourself?
Yes.
You know that little girl that fell down the well a couple years ago?
Yes. You know, I thought that was the fire department.
Oh, well, yeah, that's what you were supposed to think. You know, he likes to keep a low profile.
Yeah, I work better that way.
Then there was that time where he ran into the nuclear reactor during a meltdown.
That's all right, Carl. She didn't ask for a biography.
Sorry?
So, do you have a name, Miss,
Angela.
Angela? It's a good name. You look like an Angela.
Yeah, she does.
Okay, well, it was nice to meet you both.
Well, I hope to see you again, Angie.
Goodbye. Yeah.
I can't believe you let her get away like that.
What do you mean, let her get away?
You didn't get a work address. You didn't find out where she lives. You didn't get a phone number. You don't even know how to see her.
If you wanted those things, you could have asked her.
I meant for you. I mean, I'm not going to walk over and say,
oh, hi, Miss Angie. You know, my partner over here would really like your phone number. See, he's been very attracted to you ever since he saw your long-lost twin on television.
Well, the circumstances weren't normal. That's not the way I'm used to meeting women.
It's only because you've got too much Walter in you. You need to get more into character.
Well, this may not be for me.
Well, it's a little late for that now, isn't it? Look, we need to start creating some results in this town fast. Or they're going to start thinking that the big cops are no better than the little cops. Or they're going to figure out that we're phony.
What do you want me to do?
Become Rick Stingray, find some bad guys, and kick some butt.
I don't think so. Well, baby, it's just something I'm bored with.
Hold on. As you know, Stingray here is a very busy man.
And if you want him to keep going around and foiling all these crimes, then you better not take up too much of his time.
Mr. Stingray, how did you manage to arrest the burglar?
Huh? Oh, I found a perpetrator in the house here. And, found him going through the, lady's things with Mrs. Wilhelmina Joe Bimmingsley. And, then I, well, my instincts just kicked in.
Mr. Stingray, how did you manage to do this without injury?
I just, well, I had instinct and training in that, field.
How did you gain these instincts?
I was just born with them.
Okay, folks, that'll be all. I'll talk with y'all tomorrow. You know, Stingray, we really do appreciate your help here. We've been after this guy for a long time. You know, he doesn't really think much of law enforcement.
Yeah, I could tell.
I owe a lot to Mr. Stingray. You know, him and I got real close. I took care of him one time when he was sick. I have a lot of practice in caregiving to the sick, like this one time when my brother lost a fight with a porcupine and my mama after she ate a bad piece of fried rooster.
Afternoon, officer.
You can call me Stingray.
So, scouting the neighborhood for suspicious activity?
Actually, I was just looking for a place to eat.
Really? I thought since you were on such a roll, you'd be out looking for more.
I'm sorry?
I read about your little bus last night.
You did? Oh, you did. yeah, it's just a little bit of routine business.
Yeah, I bet it is.
Are you hungry? Would you like to get something to eat?
Oh, wow. Nothing like a direct line of questioning. You are definitely a cop.
I'm sorry. It's just...
No need to apologize. It's actually a nice change. Most guys around here just beat around the bush before they ask me out. So direct line of approach is definitely a nice change.
So do you know a good place?
So those instincts you were born with can't find you a good place to eat around here?
Well, I'm an expert at police work. I leave the restaurants around here to the prospective experts.
Oh, I see. Well, there's a good place down the street.
Well, since I'm a geography expert as well, I'd love to have lunch with someone who can teach me a few things.
Well, follow me.
Driver.
Ah! What are you, crazy? You keep doing that and this gun could go off in the car.
Okay. All right. I'll pull over. You can have a car.
What? No, I'm not a thief, you idiot. I'm a cop.
What? I am not going to get arrested. Oh, God. Oh, son of a...
have you been a cop?
About 2 years.
Oh, wow. So you must have moved up pretty fast.
Well, Carl and I, we started out as utility players and just kind of moved up from there.
I see.
So what about you? What do I need to know about Angela?
Well, Angela can't actually believe she's out with a cop right now.
Why?
Well, she's at a point in her life where she's ready to settle down. Maybe with the right person.
And a cop wouldn't be the right person.
No.
Why?
Well, think about it. Well, let's say, for example, that you and I were to get together, okay?
Okay.
I just couldn't live knowing every day that one of your fellow officers could come to our door and tell me that you'd been killed in the line of duty.
Well, I mean, accidents happen to non-law enforcement people also.
True, but the likelihood is greater.
Is it?
Yes. You've been in this for 2 years, don't you agree?
Well, yes, it's dangerous, but I'm good at what I do.
Stingray, being good has nothing to do with it. Cops killed in the line of duty weren't killed because they weren't good at what they do.
I understand.
Besides, I can't go around telling everybody my husband's name or code name is Stingray.
Okay.
And I'm sorry, I didn't mean for the conversation to go this way. It's just I feel really strongly about some things, and when I get on my soapbox, I just ramble.
No, it's okay. There's nothing wrong with knowing what you want. But if you don't mind me asking, why are you here with me after what you just told me?
Because I don't know. I wanted to. I just thought I'd put my philosophies aside and take a risk.
I'm glad you did.
Me too. So, are you a risk taker?
Well, it depends on what the risk is. My partner Carl, however, is no stranger to risk taking.
You're behind out of here before I shove this
through. All right, I'm going.
Faster.
Right, ouch!
I got you. Don't let the door hit you on the ass on the way down.
Dangerous professions aside, what do you look for in someone?
I want an equal. Someone who treats me like they want to be treated. Assuming they like to be treated well. Yeah, I guess I just want someone who will be honest with me, because I'm a very honest person.
That's good.
And I want someone who I can talk to and who I can respect and who will respect me. And some of that old-fashioned stuff, too. I guess that comes from my old-fashioned upbringing in a little country town.
That's okay.
Yeah? What about you? What do you want?
Oh, I guess more or less the same thing. Someone that's, honest.
I can see how it'd be a problem, you pulling out the cop and everything.
No. I'm sorry, Isabel. Don't let that. You know, the reason I'm just so paranoid about it is probably because I already live with someone that I have to deal with that every day.
Really, who?
My uncle.
Your uncle?
The sheriff of Purdy.
Oh, you mean Jeb.
No, he's filling in for him. His name is Chaz. He's on vacation.
So Chaz is the real sheriff. Does he know about me?
I don't know. Why?
Just curious.
I don't think so, but that's good. He'll be really glad to meet you.
Yeah, I'm sure he will.
I don't think so. Sorry, maybe next time. It's just something.
I think we have a problem.
With what?
Don't mind.
Would you mind turning Stingray off for a second?
Hi there.
What?
Jeb Jones is a fill-in.
A fill-in?
Substitute.
Substitute what?
Sheriff!
How do you know?
Angela told me. She's a real sheriff's niece. Chaz is a real sheriff's name. He's gonna be coming back from vacation any time now.
So?
So? It means trouble for us.
Why?
He may not buy into this like Jeb.
Why not? We're making headway. We don't even have to prove ourselves anymore.
Well, I was just beginning to feel comfortable with the whole thing. And there were some things that came up today that just frightened me a little.
Things? What kind of things?
Well, Angela and I were spending some time together today.
Really? A lot of time together? How far'd you get?
What?
How far did you get?
Get your mind out of the gutter. We just talked.
Too bad. We obviously need to spend more time watching Stingray love scenes.
No, Mark, we don't. Are you so caught up in this you don't see the danger that's involved?
No.
Really?
Walter, I mean, Sting, the danger here does not come anywhere close to the danger on television, okay?
Right. Aren't you worried that some of this is just a little bit too easy? We're bound to get caught.
No.
You're not worried they're bound to catch on to us.
No!
That's funny. Angela says she worries about Chaz. The job is so easy, why worry?
Because? She's a chick. Look, man, I don't know what you're feeling so guilty about. I mean, this is what you wanted.
No, I'm living a lie. I looked at that beautiful girl in the face and I lied to her about who I was.
No, you didn't, Sting. I mean, look, since you've gotten to town, have you not busted a crime or two?
Yes.
And have you not met a great-looking chick that you've fallen for that you would have never met before in your wildest dreams?
Yeah, but when she came along and looked at her, I lied to her.
No, you didn't. I know at the beginning we were stretching the rules a bit, but we've proven ourselves. We can do this. We are loved and respected in this town. All we have got to do is keep watching Stingray episodes and keep learning, and we'll keep working. We'll be a hit for good.
Yeah, but if we don't, we won't be so loved, and we'll be right back where we started.
We won't.
Are you sure?
Have I been wrong before?
Do you really think we're loved and respected?
Absolutely.
Howdy ho, neighbors! I hope I ain't imposing on any secret meetings or anything. But I just wanted to bring y'all some of my famous chocolate cake as a token of my appreciation of y'all's heroics.
Well, thank you, Wilhelmina. You sure know the way to a man's heart.
Well, yeah, that's what they say about me. It ain't always a good thing, though. I think I fed my late husband too many sweets and it went right to his heart. He had a heart attack while eating one of my fudge brownies.
Oh, well, I mean, I'm sorry.
Nah, it's okay. Half the stuff he ate clogged him up too.
Well, I mean, if he wasn't burping it up, he was spending about 2 hours passing it and stubbing up the sewer pipes.
Hey, if you want us to eat this, don't be telling us sewage stories.
Well, thank you so much, Wilhelmina.
You're welcome. If it tastes funny, give me a call.
Will do. Bye-bye.
Get the name Stingray.
What do you mean?
Well, I assume you earned the name based on the TV character.
Yeah. And you don't think it fits.
Stingray's brash is a loose cannon and dangerous risk taker. He's always putting himself in these predicaments and getting out of them in such a Hollywood way. But you're much tamer. You have more interpersonal qualities than I would expect if the other Stingray were here.
Maybe. Maybe I got it because I'm such a fan of the show.
Ah.
Probably won't always be in this profession.
Oh, really? Why not?
I have other plans. I want to do bigger things.
What do you think will make you quit someday?
Someone like you. I've really enjoyed how this job has allowed me to serve people. And there are elements of danger to it that I could walk away from. find things that I could walk toward.
Such as?
Meeting a special someone. Someone that can be an equal. Someone that treats you well. When you meet someone like that, you can change your mind about a lot of things.
I agree.
I would just hope that person would be patient with me and let me move out of the position I was in.
Absolutely.
Because I would for her. She could trust me on that. Trust is important.
He's a very bad man.
Congratulations. You're officially a cop.
Why?
Because you're eating one of these. Sure's calmed down a bit, hasn't it?
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, can I go handcuff her just for old time's sake?
How long do you want to do this?
What?
Be cops.
I don't know, I hadn't really thought much about it.
Well, I'm thinking about quitting soon.
What?
I didn't say today.
Man, I'm beginning to worry about you. Does this have to do with Angela?
Maybe.
Oh, yeah, I knew it. She turned you into a wussy boy.
No, she's not.
Oh, please. What does she want you to do? Take a gardening class? Work at a dairy?
No, I haven't thought about what I should do.
Well, she'll tell you what she wants you to do eventually.
Ugh. You don't know her like I do.
Ooh, so what?
So, she's not like that. I mean, plus I can think for myself, thank you.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Hey, you, come back here! You didn't pay!
What happened?
That punk girl just ran off with a bunch of products and she didn't pay for them.
Let's go get her.
No, no, my friend. This one's mine. You're out of room, girlfriend. What'd you steal, cutie? Some makeup? Candy? Some feminine hygiene products? Look, I'm a gentleman, so I'm gonna let you decide how we're gonna handle this. We can do this two ways. We can go into the station holding hands, or over my back. What are you gonna decide? Hey, I know you can speak English. Oh, no, wait a minute. Apparently you don't know the meaning of, hey, you need to pay for that before you leave. Well, what's it gonna be? All right, honey, we're doing it my way. Come on, let's go. Oh, you like it rough, huh? All right, I'll make it rough for you. All right. You think that's funny? My little sister hit me harder than that when she was 8 years old.
I know I'm a good news baby. I want to run far. Stay around.
You're gonna see me, all right. I'm gonna get up here in about 20 minutes. I'm gonna kick your little punk ass.
Yeah, I'll be getting up in, about 30 minutes or so.
my place at work?
Yeah, I was, and I found what I was looking for.
Me?
You.
So I'm busted.
You are.
And my sentence is?
Well, have you ever ridden in the big city?
No, never had any reason to.
Well, now you do. Ma'am, I'm afraid you're gonna have to come with me.
Fun I've had in forever. We have to do this again sometime.
Well, we will, I promise.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, it's really early. Are we gonna wake up Carl?
You kidding? He's probably on patrol.
Yeah?
Oh, man. Well, maybe he is here.
Uncle Chaz, what are you doing here?
Now that you boys understand the consequences of impersonating an officer, I should think for two grown men that would be lesson enough. After all, you were honest with me the whole time. Plus, you have helped this community. So all I ask is that you two leave quietly ASAP. I don't want a big media circus any more than you. I'll just tell them that you've done your jobs and we no longer require your services. And that will be the end of this whole thing. Understood, gentlemen?
Yes, sir.
Come on, Angela.
Angela!
I'll be right back, Uncle Chaz.
Angela, I'm so sorry. I don't know how to explain.
Yeah, well, you don't need to, because I heard everything I needed to in there.
My occupation was a fraud, but everything else was for real.
Oh, really? How would I know that? I believed you were a cop this whole time. Do you know how stupid that makes me feel? That I believed that all that time?
Look, I don't. I mean, like I said, everything else I said was for real.
Was something that you said that was really real. Remember? That you need to be with someone that you can trust? Surely you understand why right now I don't trust you.
I do.
You better go. You better go too.
Angela! Angela, my feelings for you are real!
I'm gonna get you for this, Stingray.
I don't think so.
You know, the stuff from this year is better than everything from last year.
You really want to go back to them?
I don't know what else to do. I mean, I'd rather have a job while I'm looking for a job. They will take us back.
Yeah, me too, but I don't want to go back to that one.
This is a Channel 6 news update.
Good evening, I'm Ashley Carter, live from Purdy, Texas, where our local town sheriff is being held hostage in his own home. Coming up, we'll tell you what Purdy authorities are doing to rescue Chaz Asbury. Also in local news...
What'd you do that for, man? Stingray previews are coming on.
We've got to help him.
Who? The people of Purdy, the sheriff.
Oh, yeah, the guy who kicked us out of his town? Ha ha, yeah, right.
Jeez, Mark, it's not like he was bored and he just kicked us out of town.
So?
We've got to help them.
Am I hearing you right? Mister, I don't want us to get caught in suggesting this stupid-ass idea. Mister, I don't know how much longer I can do this. I mean, you better remember what you said earlier.
I know what I said. I just feel I need to help them.
No, you don't. You're just thinking with your hormones. I mean, you're just trying to figure up some hero idea to get Angela back.
Well, you do it.
So what? That's not the point.
She probably won't even know we're there. I just want a little bit of redemption. I mean, that's all.
You want redemption? You get a real job.
Okay, why don't I turn your logic around on you?
Go ahead.
You had all the reason to take risks down there. Now you won't take a risk at all.
Hey, damn straight, I'm not going to risk getting thrown in jail.
Hey, I stood by you when you needed me. I hung in there for a long time because you couldn't do it without me. Now I just ask you to risk a little for me. I mean, why we should do it doesn't matter. We should do it because we can.
You really think they're gonna let us help?
Maybe. I think we might be able to turn Jeb and his boys around to that idea. You really want to do this?
I want to. I mean, we have nothing else to lose. Every time I hear the press saying how helpless those people are in that town, it just drives me insane. You know, I feel like I made a connection with those people. Okay, I've grown to want to help them. I feel like I should try at least one more time.
One more time, Stingray?
No. One last time is Walter. And Mark.
Okay. Walter.
What does he want?
He wants us to release three of his punks in return for the sheriff.
Can we do that?
That isn't the question. The question is, how do we get him out without giving in?
How do we do that?
Well, first of all, you don't give in.
What are you boys doing here? You should have left by now.
Well, we did, but we came back for the sheriff.
This doesn't concern you boys.
Oh, yes, it does. Look, we pledged to help you when you were shorthanded. You're shorthanded again.
That was before we knew the truth about you boys.
Well, what truth is that, Jeb? That we're not real cops?
Or that we added 10 arrests to your list and made your town a little more peaceful?
And I appreciate it too, boys. But the law said...
Yeah, well, we know. We're not here to break the law. I mean, you need help in this matter. How many hostage situations have you had?
Well, none. This is our first.
Well, then let us help you. I know we can, Jeb, and I know it's a risk, but this whole thing is a risk.
Well, I'm not taking responsibility for you.
Fine, then.
Okay. You boys have a plan?
Well, what are the demands?
Well, he wants three of his friends released in return for Sheriff Chaz.
What?
He wants three of his friends released in return for Sheriff Chaz.
What?
He wants three of his friends released in return for Sheriff Chaz.
All right, let's see him.
Who?
The three guys. Bring him in.
Well, this is him.
Are you thinking the only way we can save the sheriff is a trade?
Maybe.
Yeah, there'll be a trade, but there'll be a catch. Who do they look like to you, Jeb? If they were a look-alike contest, who would you say they look like?
Beavis and Butthead.
How about Mark and I? Do you see where I'm going with this?
Right. Yeah, we get disguised as them.
Right.
But what about her?
I better have a big part considering I'm missing Hee-Haw.
Well, Jeb, will this do?
Well, good enough. It'll be too dark outside for them to tell the real difference anyway.
Okay, here's a plan. We agree to have an exchange between the house and the car. When we reach the bad guy, we jump on him and cuff him. Jeb will draw his pistol to back us up. Wilhelmina, do not throw yourself on him. You got it? Just run.
I guess so.
Okay, Mark. Give him a buzz.
Are they all there?
Yes, they are. How's Chaz?
He's breathing. Now listen to me carefully. I'll walk outside with Chaz. On the count of three, we walk the exchange together. If my friends aren't walking at the same pace, or you try anything funny, I shoot the sheriff. Got it?
I got it. Okay. You all get ready.
Gate.
Fair enough. Yo-hoo! I said, yo-hoo!
I guess we answer.
Yo-ho!
Yo-ho!
Howdy-ho!
Okay! We walk in 3, 2, 1! Walk!
What's up, guys?
Ah!
Hold me to no! Guys, back off! Oh, no. You! You'll regret this!
You guys shouldn't have come back.
Oh, come on. Is that any way to talk to someone who just saved your life?
I'm afraid there's a little more to it than that.
What do you mean?
They've got my niece in there, too.
What? Angela?
That's why police business is for police. Hello?
You guys think you're so smart, don't you? I knew I would need an insurance policy. You start playing by my rules now or sweet little Angela gets it.
That'll just make matters worse. What do you want? I'll bring him to you. All right. All right, I understand. Yes. Okay. Okay. He wants me to hand deliver them alone. And to bring them alone, unarmed, by myself, and pull this off.
You can't do that.
I can if it means Angela lives.
We need to negotiate more.
Your chance for that was long gone when you let these guys be part of the operation.
I know. I was desperate. Chaz, look. Hey, Walter, where are you going, man?
Hey, Walter, stop or I'll arrest you.
Hello? Walter, what are you doing?
I'm going in.
Are you crazy?
Yes.
Okay, look, this isn't a fantasy anymore, all right? This is not an episode of Stingray. This is real life with real people and real guns.
I know. I know.
What
does he think he's doing?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Couldn't exactly get much out of him.
Jeez, this is freaking crazy. Jeb, this idea with these guys has done more harm than good.
Sir, that man loves your niece. Now, I don't know if any of these guys could do. And that makes two people whose lives he's put his life on the line for that he didn't have to. And, I mean, not even to count all the people whose lives he saved while you were off vacationing. Now, I think we should show my friend just a little bit of respect and a little bit of faith.
Ahem.
You got a lot of nerve coming in here.
Yo, Rex.
What? What'd you call me? My name's not Rex.
Hello, miss. Got anything to drink in there?
I think there's some cola and some lemonade.
Got any milk?
I think there's some in there, but I think it's spoiled.
That'll be fine.
If I don't see or hear something soon, I'm going in.
Give him a little more time. Let me ask you something, Rex.
I told you my name's not Rex!
You kill her, and then what's next?
Maybe I'll just kill you as well.
I'd like to see you try.
Well, what makes you think I won't?
Well, couldn't I just foil your plan before you get to all that?
Yeah, right. Whatever. I'd like to see you try.
Would you? Would you really?
Hey, man, maybe I'd kill you first.
I don't think so.
That does it. I'm going in.
Hey, guys, he's in the kitchen.
Just focus on your duty, sir.
Still in shock that I was able to pull this off.
Don't forget about me.
How could I? You're the reason I'm here.
I know.
How'd you manage to stay so calm and take that guy out?
Well, it's just something I'm born with.
This idea with these guys has done more harm than good.
Sir? That man in there loves your wife.
You're actually supposed to stop.
It's got to be cut. The fence has got to be fixed. The trash has got to be taken out.
I'm sorry.
This world, there's a lot more to it than... He's looking...
Wait a minute, what is
Rex Kipler?
Again.
I mean, the chief is about to go nuts, ranting and raving about having your back.
Yeah, whatever. If he'd been off on one of his tangents, the less you saw.
The chief is about to go nuts, ranting and raving about having your badge.
Yeah, whatever. If he'd taken my badge the last time he went off on one of his tirades. God damn.
Hello?
Go.
What if I get to you first?
You miss my
wait, stop.
What? What's the matter?
My shadow.
Oh, my. Oh!
Aaron.
Oh.
Is that you?
Sting?
Yeah, what?
Okay. Sorry.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2.
I think we have a problem.
Have you considered Viagra? I'm sorry, I couldn't remember what I was supposed to say.
What is it?
What's that? What's that?
I think we have a problem.